Good evening, welcome to another video from Referit. Friends, look at the board. Here three sentences are written on the board. He is a teacher, they don't like sweets, she has a diamond ring. If you observe all these three sentences, you can find here is, don't like, has. What do you think of these words? These are helping to know the state of action and about the action. So these words give us information about actions and the state of action. So the word which gives us information about actions, action and state of action. So the word which is used to express actions and state of actions is called verb. Today our topic is verb. Verb is a word which express, okay, the definition of the verb is a word which expresses the actions and state of actions. Here in all these sentences, verb gives us the information about the actions and the state of actions. And from this verb, we can know the tense of the sentence also. That's why, in my opinion, verb is the life of a sentence. Verb is a life of the life of a sentence. Okay. In my opinion, verb is the life of a sentence. That's why it's a very important topic in the English language. So today we are going to learn about verbs. Okay, here verbs are divided into many types. Verbs are divided into many types. Here if you see, here is, and this is has, and here do also used to write the negative sentence. All this is, has and do, these are called auxiliary verbs. Friends, verbs are divided into many types, but today we are going to learn something about auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary verbs means helping verbs. These auxiliary verbs are of two types. Okay, one is primary auxiliary verbs, and the second one, modal auxiliaries. So these are auxiliary verbs. Verbs are divided into many types, but today we are learning about auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary verbs are again divided into primary auxiliaries and modal auxiliaries. Now let me teach you in detailed version about primary auxiliary verbs. Primary auxiliary verbs are of three types. First one, be forms. Second one, do forms. And third one, have forms. In this video, we are going to learn about be forms. So, let me introduce you some be forms. What are be forms here? Is, am, are, was, were, be, being, and been. These are be forms. These all are forms of be. These are all be forms. As we all know, is, am, are, they are present tense be forms. Is, was, been. Am, was, been. Are, were, been. Okay, next, this being and been are other forms of be form. Is, was, been. Is present form of be is. Past form of be was. Past participle form is been. Like that, am, was, been, or were, been. These are all be forms. Is, am, are used in simple present tense and present continuous tense. These three are used in simple present tense and present continuous tense. But was and were, these was and were are past forms of be. They are used in simple past and past continuous tenses. But what about be, being, been? Been is used in present perfect continuous tense, present perfect continuous tense, and passive forms also. This being also, it is used in continuous tenses while writing passive forms. Then be also, it is used in future tense. Okay. Now, let me tell you how we use all these be forms, both present be forms and past be forms. How do we use after nouns and pronouns? Okay, let me tell you. As we all know, I and we, these two are first personal pronouns. And next one, you and you, these two are second personal pronouns. And he, she, it, they, these are third personal pronouns. But what about noun, singular noun and plural noun? For example, Rama. And next, fruits. Okay, here I, after I, we use present and be forms. Always we use only I am. Am only is used after I. But we, as it is plural pronoun, we have to take plural be form. That is, we are, you are, you are. But here, when we come to third personal pronouns, he, she, and it, these three are singular pronouns. That's why we use he is, she is, it is. But they, it is plural pronoun. That's why we use only are. But don't use he am, it's wrong. She am, it's wrong. idiom, it's wrong. Okay, but we should always use he is, she is, it is, they are. I am, but I is incorrect. We are correct. You are. So this is how we have to use these be forms after personal pronouns. And when we come to names, Rama is. But don't use Rama am. It's incorrect. But what about fruits? Fruits is a plural noun. That's why we should take plural be form. Fruits are. So these are all present tense be forms. And I have told you how these present tense be forms are used after these personal pronouns and nouns, both singular and plural. But what about past tense be forms, was and were? It is singular, that's why we should take I was. We, plural, so we were. Next, you, both singular and plural, that's why we should only use we were. So you were, like that. But here, he, she, and it, these three are singular pronouns. That's why in the past tense, we take the be form he was, she was, it was, but they were. But Rama was, as it is singular, we should take singular be form was. Fruits were, as fruits is the plural noun, we should take plural be form were. So this is how we have to use these be forms after personal pronouns and nouns. Okay, now let me tell you what is the use of these be forms. What are the uses of be forms? Okay, here be forms are used in some cases. First use of these be forms is, these be forms are used to introduce a person or a thing or an object. So be forms are used to introduce a person or a thing or an object. So like this we can use. Okay, here this is Rao. So this is the introduction of Mr. Rao. This is Rao. They are students from St. Joseph's. He is Mr. Verma. He is Mr. Verma. So this is how we can introduce a person or a thing or an object using this be form. So be forms are used to introduce a person or thing or an object. The second usage of these be forms is, to describe a person or thing or an object. Okay, now let me tell you some examples. He is an engineer. So here is used. If it is plural, the subject is plural. They are robbers. They are robbers. Okay? They are robbers. fruits, fruits are tasty, fruits are tasty, fruits are tasty. So to describe a person or a thing or an object, these be forms are used. These be forms are used. Next one, third usage of these be forms. Third usage of these be forms. Third one, to tell present situation. To tell present situation. To tell present situation. He is rich. They are billionaires. They are billionaires. He is rich. Like that we can tell present situation of a person or a thing or an object using these be forms. The last and the fourth usage of these be forms are to express, to express age, size and weight. To express age, size and weight, we use these be forms. To express age, he is 21 years old. He is 21 years old. She is 18 years old. Okay, here he is, she is. Okay, they are of 50 years old. They are of 50 years old. And size, size, he is very fat. He is very fat. She is very thin. She is very thin. But what about weight? I am 70 kilos of weight. I am 70 kilos of weight. She is 55 kgs of weight. So like that we can use these be forms in sentences. Be forms are used in different ways. The first one, to introduce a person, we can use be forms. The second one, to describe a person, we can use be forms. Third one, to express present situation of a person or object or thing, we can use these be forms. Next, fourth one, to express age, size and weight, we use these be forms. So these are the uses of be forms. Okay, thank you for watching this video.